الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله This is our sixth day for the prophetic biography صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الحبيب العلي القدر العظيم الجاه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم Today we are going to start the sixth chapter about the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam servants among freemen. His servants among freemen are Hazrat Anas ibn Malik, Hazrat Hind and Asma, both daughters of Haritha, Hazrat Rabia bin Ka'ab, Hazrat Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Hazrat Uqba ibn Amir, Hazrat Bilal, Hazrat Sa'ad, Hazrat Duh Mikhmar, the nephew of Negus, Hazrat Bukhair ibn Shaddaq al-Laythi and Hazrat Abu Dal al-Ghaffari radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. May Allah ta'ala be well pleased with them all. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guards. Those who serve as his guards are Hazrat Sa'ad ibn Mu'ad on the day of battle of Badr, Hazrat Dakhwan ibn Abd Qais and Muhammad bin Ibn Maslama were his guards in the battle of Uhud. Hazrat Zubair in the Battle of Trench, Hazrat Abbad ibn Bishr, Sa'ad ibn Waqas, and Hazrat Abu Ayyub in the Battle of Khaybar, Hazrat Bilal in the Wadi al-Qura, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. May Allah ta'ala be well pleased with them all. When the following words was revealed, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dispensed with guards. Wallahu ya'asimuka minan nas, and Allah shall protect you from men. And his emissaries. Hazrat Amr ibn Umayyah radiyallahu anhu was his envoy to Najashi, the king of Abbasin, whose name was Ashama. Najashi placed a letter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam upon his eyes, climbed down from his throne, sat on the ground and accepted Islam. Najashi died in the year 9 Hijri and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam held his funeral prayer in Abyssinia. Hazrat Dihya ibn Khalifa al-Kalbi was the emissary to Caesar, the king of Rome, whose name was Hercules. He recognized and acknowledged the prophethood of Rasulullah and he contemplated accepting Islam, but the Romans Christians opposed him. He feared their pleasure and held back from becoming a Muslim. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Hudhafa al-Sahmi radiyallahu an was emissary to Chosroes, the king of Persian. May Allah damnation be upon him. He tore the letter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the news reached, he, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, "May Allah ta'ala cleave his kingdom and rend his asunder." Hazrat Hatib ibn Abi Baltah radiyallahu an was an envoy to Muqawqis, who came close to accepting Islam. He presented the bondsman Maria and her sister Sirin an amul named Duldul, and it is said that also he sent 1,000 gold coins and garments, 20 of which were made of silk. Hazrat Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu an was the emissary to Ja'far and Abd, the two sons of Julada, the two king of Oman. They both became Muslim and they relinquished their authority in favor of verdict of Hazrat Amr concerning charity and commandments. He stayed there until the passing of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hazrat Salis ibn Amr al-Amiri was the envoy to Hawda ibn Ali, the chief of Yamama, who honored him and sent his reply to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What a beautiful message what you bring and beckon us towards. I am the orator in my community and their poet. I ask you to grant me the autonomy in some parts of religion. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam refused and Hawda did not accept Islam. Hazrat Shuja ibn Wahab al-Sa'di radiyallahu an was sent to Harith ibn Abu Shamir al-Ghassani, the king of Levant. He flung the messenger of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "I shall invade him." Caesar stopped him from attempting to do so. Muhajir ibn Umayyah al-Makhzumi radiyallahu an was sent an emissary to Harith al-Himyari in Yemen. Hazrat Ala ibn al-Hadrami was sent to Mundir ibn Sawa, the king of Bahrain, who accepted Islam. Hazrat Abu Musa al-Ashari was sent to Yemen along with Mu'ad ibn Jamal radiyallahu an. The entire Yemen population and their king became Muslims without any resistance or putting up a fight. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's scribes. Among those What his scribes are four righteously guided caliphs. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu an, Hazrat Umar radiyallahu an, Hazrat Usman and Hazrat Ali radiyallahu anhuma. And some others scribers are Hazrat Amir ibn Fuhara, Hazrat Abdullah ibn Arqam, Hazrat Ubay ibn Ka'ab, Hazrat Sabit bin ibn Shammas, Hazrat Khalid ibn Sa'id, Hazrat Hanzila bin Rabi, Hazrat Zaid ibn Thabit, Hazrat Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, and Hazrat Shurabil ibn Hasana radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. May Allah Ta'ala be pleased with them all. Headsmen. Among those who carried executions upon his commands were Hazrat Ali alayhi salam, Hazrat Zubair radiyallahu an, Hazrat Muhammad bin Maslama radiyallahu an, Hazrat Athim ibn Thabit bin Abi Aqla, and Hazrat Miqdad radiyallahu anhuma. May Allah Ta'ala be well pleased with them all. And his lieutenants, those among his companions who were his lieutenants, Hazrat Abu Bakr, Hazrat Umar, Hazrat Ali, Hazrat Hamza, Hazrat Ja'far, Hazrat Abu Dhur, Hazrat Miqdad, Hazrat Salman, Hazrat Hudhayfa, Hazrat Ibn Mas'ud, Hazrat Ammar, and Hazrat Bilal radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. The 10 given glad tidings of the paradise are: the 10 who were giving the glad tidings of the paradise, and the 4 righteously guided caliphs, Hazrat Umar, Hazrat Umar, Hazrat Uthman, and Hazrat Ali karramallahu wajh radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. And the following 6 are: Hazrat Zubair ibn al-Awwam, Hazrat Sa'ad ibn Waqas, Hazrat Abdurrahman bin Auf, Hazrat Talha ibn Ubaidullah, Hazrat Sa'ad ibn Zayd, and Hazrat Abu Ubaida Amir ibn al-Jarrah radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam's blessed animals. Historians have differed about the number of horses Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam owned. The names of 10 of his horses are Sakhb, which he rode in Uhud, and he had a blaze white legs and was marked on 2 legs. Murtajis, that which Khuzaymah ibn Thabit bore witness for. Lizaz, presented to him by Muqawqis. Lahif, presented to him by Rabi'ah ibn Abi Barra. Zarib, presented to him by Farah al-Judaymi. Ward, gifted to him by Tamim al-Dari, Daras. Mulawi, and Sabaha, which participated in the race, and his horse won the race. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was pleased by this. Bahar, a horse he purchased from a Yemen merchant and thrice won the race. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam wiped his face and said, "Truly, you are an ocean." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam had 3 mules. Duldul, gifted by Muqawqis, it was the first mule that was ridden in Islam. Fida and Aliyah, a gift from the king of Ayla. He also had a donkey named Yafur, and as for cattle, it is not reported which he owned any cows or bullock. He had 20 milch camels in the woods. Sa'ad ibn Ubaidah radiyallahu anhu had a she camel sent from the stock of Bani Uqail. He had a she camel named Qaswa, and he rode it on the journey of Medina during migration. He did not receive revelation while riding except on this animal. It is also said that it is the very she camel that was named Adba. He had another female camel named Jada. This is the camel that fell behind a race, and because of which Muslim was saddened. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is a law of Allah and befitting whatever rises in the world should wane and decline. It is also said that the losing camel was the another one. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had hundreds of sheep, and he had an ear named Ghaitha, and he would drink from its milk, and he had a white cockerel. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala al-Nabi al-Ummi wa alihi. Sadaqallahu al-Azim.